Welcome back to my channel, everyone. Tiff Benson here, and today we're going to be talking about a boozy scent that I've been loving and testing. So if you want to hear my thoughts on Melon and Guts Dark Rum, make sure you keep watching. Thank you for joining me today. I'm super happy that you're here with me. And also, let me just remind you to turn on your notifications. Some people say that they're getting my notifications. Some people say that they aren't. So make sure you turn on your notifications so you can be notified. Leave a comment right now and let me know what your scent of the day is. Today, mine is obviously dark rum. Also, let me know in the comments if you like boozy scents. I am obsessed, literally obsessed with boozy scents. To me, they just scream fall, which is why I feel like this is an appropriate one to talk about. So let's talk a little bit about Melon and Guts. They are a modern apothecary brand known for their luxury skincare. They're based out of New York City, and it just so happens that dark rum is one of their signature best sellers. This comes in a parfum, a toilette, they have a soap, they also have a perfume oil, and I also think they have a lotion. So this is a heavily dominated scent in their line. And again, it's their best seller. The one that I'm going to be discussing today is their EDT version. Now, I got mine through Scentbirds. And if you don't know what Scentbirds is, it's a subscription-based fragrance service. They send you these really large, this is really large, right? It's a large size sample of any fragrance that you like. It's supposed to last you 30 days, but I feel like it lasts even longer. If you have commitment issues like me, you don't want to commit, and you know who you are out there who have commitment issues too. It's perfect. You get to test out your fragrance, see if it works for you, and if it doesn't, it's okay. So apparently I'm a little late to the party on this one. Throughout the month of October, they had a buy one, get one offer. So if this is something that you're interested in, don't miss out. Check the description box below. It has notes of plum, bergamot, anise. Middle notes are leather, rum, and vanilla. And the base notes are patchouli, amber, and milk. Now, everyone knows the obsession right now that I am having with plum fragrance. This one has a pretty dominant plum note, and if I had to describe this fragrance, I would say it smells like a dark plum cocktail. It is just so good. I sprayed this on this morning, and for some reason, it made me think of Thanksgiving, so I wonder, this might be something that I could wear for my Thanksgiving moment. This one has low to moderate sillage. It kind of does wear close to the skin, which I'm okay with because a lot of times boozy scents are so boozy and it smells like you just came from a bar crawl. And I hope everyone knows what bar crawl is. I might be telling too much about myself. But anyway, not overly done on the booze note, heavy on the plum note, and it has a beautiful amber patchouli dry down. Definitely digging this for the fall season. I feel like it's perfect for this cooler weather, and I feel like it would perform best during the colder months. When it comes to longevity, so far I feel like I've been getting 5 hours, maybe 5 hours plus out of it, up or down. Again, this is gonna wear a little bit lighter, and once it dries down, it will wear close to the skin like a skin scent, which I'm okay with. It's completely unisex and it's being marketed as a fragrance for men and women, so this will not disappoint you if you like fragrances that are gender bending. So my final verdict on this is yes, I do like it. I will be wearing it. I probably will end up wearing this for my Thanksgiving Day scent because something about it just made me feel festive and warm, and it's oddly intoxicating. So yeah, I'll be wearing it then. Leave a comment right now and let me know if you've tried Dark Rum by Melon and Guts, and also let me know if you've tried Scentbirds. What do you think about these companies? I'm so curious. Thank you so much for watching. I love you forever. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one. Different outro today, but it is the same message. Thank you so much for being here. You make this channel possible, and I love you for it. Sharing is caring, so make sure to share this video with a friend who also loves fragrance. And if you've made it all the way to the end of this video, make sure you write Plum Cocktail in the comments.